Well, no, I did something kind of dumb. I lost this video. Don't know how I did it, but I lost it. But I found it, and better late than ever, I figure. And I'll go ahead and show this stuff to you because you might find something useful in here. I do a lot of cleaning of the radio, a little bit of work on the pots and things like that. So I hope you find something you like. Let me know if you have any comments, and here we go. All right, I have been working on this balance control for some time now. The problem is the balance control was really stiff, and they weren't getting sound out of one of their speakers, but I know that it was a balance control problem, a potentiometer problem, because when I would move the thing, sometimes it would crackle in and crackle out, so that's the classic sign of a filthy pot that just needs to be cleaned. And I've been working on this. Problem is it's a sealed potentiometer, and I'll show a picture of it shortly. But there's no way into it except to take the deoxit and just spray it in this gap between the shaft and the bushing that the shaft rides in, and turn it and turn it and turn it. And then I used my old lacquer thinner trick. So I sprayed the deoxit on there, then I would dribble lacquer thinner. And what that did was that carried the deoxit into the potentiometer. And I kept doing that and get plenty of it inside of there. And you turn it and start turning more freely, And ultimately, I would start to put a little more deoxit, a little less lacquer thinner, and kind of get a lot of it in that cavity of that pot. Now, the only caveat of that is that it's going to have to sit now for a long time to dry, because this sealed pot will eventually dry out of there, but it takes a long time. So that's why I did it early in this project, so I could be done with it and give it some time to rest. Okay, so I want to remove knobs to clean them. And so let me, I already took the first pair off, the ones on the left, so let me take these left ones off. On these Grundigs, these knobs are held on with very small set screws. And you have to look for them, there we go. So you loosen the set screws. These are little standard screwdriver, there we go. Little flat bladed screwdriver. If I can get the screwdriver in there. All right. Okay, that should be loose enough. Okay, knob number one. Little felt ring between the two knobs. Knob number two. Okay. Pretty dirty behind the knob, as one would expect, and it's a dust, but it's a real sticky dust that I'm going to have to do a little bit of work to clean off of there. So the first step is just take and gently wipe most of that dust away. No point in polishing the dust, so get most of it away. There will be all kinds of other icky things, hair and stuff like that you just have to deal with. Okay, so now I have already done this side of the dial face. So I don't know if you can see it. You can see the reflection, the difference in the reflection. So this side over here is not done. And right about here, it starts to transition to where I have polished it. It's, you know, it'll make it staticky and want to attract dust. That's okay, that'll pass. Okay, so real simple. I've talked about this before. You want to use this 3M extra cut compound. It's good stuff. Shake it. I've already shaken this, but shake it pretty well to get the abrasives in, you know, evenly in solution. And this is, by the way, this is a plastic dial face. A lot of these German radios, these are glass. And there's no point in doing what I'm doing right now on glass, okay? I'm polishing the surface of the plastic to make it more shiny. The printing is on the other side, so I don't have to worry about that. So I can polish it with a little bit of gusto. I mean, I don't want to go crazy, but with a little bit of gusto, try and get this, I want to get this clean and shiny so it looks more new. And plus, there will be little deposits and stuff that are on there that this will remove. Don't push too hard in any one spot. You don't want to crack the plastic. I mean, it is thick and it's pretty robust, but you never know. And the last thing you want to do is damage a dial face on one of these old German radios. You try to find one. If you know where to find them, you're a lucky person, because I have no idea. I'm working on a Telefunken right now that's got a cracked dial face. And right now I'm at the point of trying to figure out how I can put the two pieces that are cracked cleanly, or broken, it's not cracked, broken, but it's broken cleanly, put the two pieces together and make the crack not quite so visible. That's how bad it is to try and get a dial face for one of these. You don't have to make a career of this. You just want to get it to look good, and you polish it until it starts to dry and starts to shine. Okay. You'll find as you're doing it little places where the deposits aren't quite clean. So you'll work a little more on those areas. You'll find that you want to spread the polishing compound around. It's not fun to get out of cracks and stuff like that if you have to. So now, if I were going to remove this thing, there would be nothing to polish on the backside, because all of this dye, this is clear plastic that has been painted on the backside. And so all this brown is paint, and there'd be no point polishing that, because even if I made it shiny on the surface that you could see, you wouldn't be able to see it through the front side. The spring weather has hit, and I spent yesterday, when I should have been doing this, I spent wax in my car. I got it repaired at the body shop recently, and they polished it. And right after that, we got a lot of snow. And of course, you know, the politicians here are afraid they'll lose their snow allotment if they don't all use it and run out before the end of the year. Every year they always have to whine if they've run out of snow. Well, they do that because they put way too much on the road. Well, I don't want to drive this freshly painted clean car on a road full of salt. So I've been driving wifey's old Subaru and, you know, telling myself that I would wax my car at least so that, it, you know, I could take advantage of the freshly polished paint or freshly polished car. And I finally got around to it yesterday. I don't really enjoy doing that. And so I kept putting it off. Well, I can't drive wifey's old Subaru forever. Pretty soon she's going to be recovered enough that she's going to need to drive it herself. So I spent the day waxing a car. And I used to look forward to doing that, and now I don't like it. There's some sticky stuff up here that I'm going to have to find some other way of getting off. I'm not sure what in the world that is. And then you take a soft cloth and you buff it. And you make it look real nice, see? By the way, you do the buttons the same way. I've done these buttons, and they have a real nice look to them now. You don't want to use any solvents on this like you could on glass to get sticky stuff off, because I don't know what it'll do to the plastic. So you just have to work it until you kind of wear off stickiness sometimes. But it's amazing how, because there are little windows that are, you know, in the paint in this glass, so you can see things that are behind the plastic, and it gets cloudy from all the dirt and stuff, and it's amazing how a little polishing will straighten that right up. A good example of that are these little tone controls. There are windows right here. And when you move the tone control, it moves this little light diffuser behind it to kind of give you an indicator of where you have the tone control set. Well, when this plastic gets real dirty and oily, it gets cloudy and you can't see that what's going on behind the window. But now it's real clear and looks real nice. I haven't quite figured out what to do about these knobs yet. You even have to get the area right in front of this button. When you push the button down, there's some printing that's under it. You have to get that because that's very, very visible with the radio and with the chassis in the cabinet. So you have to get all that clean. It's hard because typically on these German radios, these buttons are glued onto the shaft, so you can't just pull them off. I tried once and I destroyed a button doing that. I won't do that again. These, I think, are made of phenolic because they have a smell to them when you're polishing them. And that brown comes off on your cloth. You can see that. It comes off on the cloth when you're doing it. That's typical of phenolic or Bakelite. This gets it clean, but it also puts a little bit of a surface on it to give it some gloss. See, I'm polishing it until it starts to dry, and it'll start to shine through the dry. You can also smell it more when I get to that point because the abrasive does most of its work in that last few seconds of it drying, and that's when you smell it, when the abrasive is working. Most of what I just polished you will never see because it'll be behind the other knob, but it still gives, you need to give it continuity. So that's the inside of that knob. Nice look to it. You're not using much of this polishing compound at a time. And by the way, just so you know, I'm going to wash this knob afterward to get the polishing compound out of all the little fluting crevices. Get it pretty, guys. This is where the image of the radio comes from for the owner or for you. Make it pretty. Give it that curve appeal. Remember, you want to attract someone to the radio to see it, or you'll never get a chance to talk about it. Doesn't matter how much gets down in this little fluting, because I'm going to clean that out with a toothbrush and soap and water. I would do the same to this tone control knob, except I don't want to take that off of there. It's part of the tone control. It's integral, and it would be a nightmare to get that out and put it back. I'm sure it could be done, but there's no, that wouldn't make sense to do. All right, there we go. Like I mentioned, I'm going to clean the fluting lines out with some soap and water. But the shine will remain. Nice looking knob. This is tedious work, I understand, but it really makes a difference when you do it. All right, there's the knob. I will clean all that stuff out of there in some soapy water shortly. It's nice and shiny. That's what matters. I buy this stuff. I bought this on Amazon. And I think the site I bought it from was packaging it for use when cleaning, you know, car stuff. But I bought it for working on tape recorders. This is 99.8% isopropyl alcohol. It's good stuff. I keep the cap closed tightly and I keep it in a cool spot. So it takes some effort to open the cap, and I'm going to go ahead and use this to work on this knob. Pour a little bit in this little cap here. I don't need a lot, but I don't want to contaminate what's in the bottle by dipping a brush in the bottle. And let's see if that works. Boy, I love that smell. Well, it's not really cutting it very well, is it? There we go. Maybe it's just got to soak for a bit. It's kind of pokey, guys, but it's safe. I would not recommend. Lacquer thinner would be faster, but it'd wind up maybe damaging the plastic. Or little splatters of it would damage other parts in the plastic. Okay. So it is going to work. It's going to take forever, but it'll work. I hope it doesn't take that paint off that indicator on the knob. But I got to get this clean because you can't see the indicator without that anyway. Okay, so once it gets it wet and it sits and soaks for a minute, it does pretty good. Pretty well. So you get it wet, you let it sit for a second, and then you scrub it. And boy, oh boy, is that... That's an interesting pot there. So this switch is, the pot is integral with this switch. And I'm going to have to clean that out with some lacquer thinner, though. Holy moly. What you have here on this, attached to the knob, inside this little pot device, are two arms that straddle the knob, on each side of the knob. When you turn the knob, these two arms rotate inside of the pot. At the ends of each of the arms, okay, it looks kind of like this actually, at the end of each of the arms is a contact point, like a carbon point, whatever, and it rides in a little track, and I'm not clear yet whether that track is wire wound or carbon, but I imagine it's carbon. And so I'm cleaning right now that track with some lacquer thinner first, and then with some, I'll do some deoxit after. But first I need to get most of the greasy crap out of there to make this thing work better. So let's do that first. Now we'll go ahead and try it with the rubbing alcohol. Okay, it's fairly clean. And we'll clean around the outside of it while I'm here. Okay, before I finish cleaning this little knob, I think I'll go ahead and spray. Get the other one while I'm thinking about it. Just like anytime you use deoxit, you work it back and forth a whole bunch of times. That'll loosen crap and kind of break it free and wipe the surface clean, and then you flush it out with more deoxit. Getting low on deoxit, that's not good because that's my last can right now. When I get paid from this job, pretty much all the money from this job is going to buy some replenishing supplies because I overspent on other stuff lately. I'm buying a turntable and a cabinet for that turntable and so forth. And I've been kind of ignoring the things like, I better get some parts on the way and some supplies. That's okay. Wouldn't be the first time that happened. As you might have noticed, I don't sprout roots after finishing a job. I get moving on right into the next job. And that's not because I'm any kind of fabulous worker. It's because I really want to get to my radios. And the only way I can do that is to treat these people the right way that have left their radios with me and get their stuff done. So this alcohol is doing a fine job once I get it wet and let it sit for a minute and it's cleaning this. And when it splatters, it doesn't hurt the dial cover. Yeah, this is working really well. This is the first time I've tried this on knobs that are captive like this. I will remember this. Okay. I'm going to spray just a little more deoxid in there. Yeah, these will be sweet now. Let them dry. It'll be days before I hook this all back up, so that's good for these. Looks easy, and it kind of is easy. Boy, these switches do get dirty, or these push buttons do get dirty. Polished them, I neglected to get the sides of them. And I see the folly of my mistake now. It's not done until it's clean. Okay, so these are done. These are done. I sprayed those from the top side with deoxid, got them the best I could. The reason I do that, I've explained in our record player video I did. If you mix solvent and oil together, what it does is it lowers the surface tension of that oil. In other words, it helps it to flow into places. And then that solvent will evaporate and the oil will remain, and you can lubricate things that are harder to get to, that have tighter fit that way. Lots and lots of pots I have been able to get to work properly this way, but it takes a lot of time. And this was the principal cause of the reason they first brought the radio to me, is that they weren't getting sound out of one speaker. But I knew that both channels were working. It was the balance control that was not working properly. All right, hopefully this will square us away. Okay, so cosmetically, I'm in pretty good shape on this radio on the front side. I'm washing the knobs right now. This is all polished and looking really good the way it's supposed to look. I've deoxided the two-tone controls, this one right here, cleaned them up with alcohol. That's a pretty good way to get them clean without causing any problems, any damage to the plastic. And made everything cosmetically good, and I can get back to the function of the radio now. Okay, let's get back to the radio. Now I'm going to get on with cleaning the top side of the chassis. There's a lot involved there as well. Let's turn it where we can all see it. It's a big flat chassis made of fairly thin metal, so it's kind of flexible. And I want to be careful about moving it around. I'm just going to go ahead and that's so clean, I don't really need to mess with it. And there's no way the bearings are set up differently than in other radios, and I'd have to take this apart to get anything in there to clean that out. It works so well, I'm just going to leave it alone. I'm going to give it a quick shot of deoxid on those fingers. Actually, I'll do that when I can operate it. And I'm just going to call it good because this thing looks good. What I will do, however, is clean these tubes and take a look at the tube sockets while I'm there. So I'm going to remove these tubes one by one, because I don't want to lose track of where they go, and just wipe them off, okay? It's a GE tube, EL95, all right. I will go ahead and do that. It's pretty boring work. I'll come back to it. I'll probably be ready to test this radio on the speakers very soon and see where we're at. Well, this video was a little out of sequence with all of the other ones, only because I thought I'd never recorded the video in the first place, but then I found it in a file that I didn't realize was there. So here it is. I hope some of it's been useful to you. By the time you see this, you'll have seen that I got this radio working just fine, and I'm getting ready to move on to my next project. So this is it for the lost video, and this is it from Michael on Thursday night, March the 9th, from your Western Outpost in Salt Lake City. That's all for now. Good night.